We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
That is chapter number 10, Enhancing User Experience, where we are going to see few things. That is action, introduction of the action bar that we have on our activity. You can say the title bar, right? That where we can add few menu icons, some action view and some action provider, so that we are going to see in action bar. Then we will see the menu, two types of menu that we can create, right, by using XML and Java. Totally 3 types of menu is there in Android, but there are 2 ways to create it. So that menus and dialogues that we will see, then drawables and gradient we will see, and the custom animation, that all things we are going to learn in this particular chapter. Okay, let's start. So first thing, that what is action bar is there, and when that particular feature is introduced in Android. So as you see on your screen, right, action bar is introduced in Android 3.0 API level, that is 11, right? Before it, action bar is not there, only a title bar is over there. And whatever you see right here, 3 dots at the right side, right? So that is the menu, that physical button is available in older phone. But after the API 11, they have changed their concept, okay? And they have introduced that option menu as a part of action bar. So the action bar that provide a consistent framework for providing the branding for your application, or you can say you can utilize the action bar as the navigation and the surface key for the entire your application or the activity. Where you just see one example is given, a black color action bar is there on your screen, where a app icon is given, a app title is given, and 3 dots that denote that the menu is over there. So the action bar is enabled by default, right? If you use any activity that have the default theme, that is theme.holo, or any SDK version that you are using as a targeted SDK in your application that is higher than the 11 API, that action bar by default available into that. But if you are working with less than 11 API, right, only title bars are there, right? So how you can enable the action bar nowadays? We are working on the higher version of the SDK, so action bar is by default available, but in our older version you need to think about that. Okay, now how you can enable it, right? So as we have already discussed, you need to set the targeted version that is higher than the 11. So action bar is available. As you all know, right, the textbook that you are using, that is written on 2.4, right, that is Froyo. So at that time, that API level is 8. So they explicitly say that targeted version need to be set that is greater than that, more than 11, right? Then and only then this thing is available. So that is must. But in today's scenario, it is of course greater than this 11 SDK version. So by default, that action bar is available. But in any case, if you wish to hide action bar, or just want to make the toggle from hide to show and show to height, then you can utilize some coding techniques. Just see on your screen, we have a created one object of action bar that can be created using get action bar method. This dot get action bar, that is the method, right, that you can utilize within your activity, and it will provide you the object of action bar, and that object that you can utilize to call the method of action bar, that is hide and show, as listed on your screen. When you call method hide, of course your action bar is going to hide, and when you call again it show, it will available on your screen. Now many times it is possible, right, you want to disable the action bar. So it can be done in a several way. One is that you just go in the Android manifest file, and when you are registering your activity, where you can select a style for your activity with the theme attribute, right? Just see, we have utilized here activity Android name equal to dot my non action bar activity. So that's a class name. And the another thing, that's a theme attribute we are providing, where we denote that at the rate Android style theme dot holo dot no action bar. That means in this particular activity, there should not be any action bar. So where we can utilize this kind of thing. So if you see, when your application is start, it comes with the splash screen, and splash screen does not contain any kind of action bar. So to create this kind of things, right, you can remove action bar. Another alternative way that is given, that you can customize your own theme. That means by using system theme that is available in Android, you can create your own style. So in a style.xml, you need to write this content that is given in a second bullet point, right, where you need to specify a new style, that is no action bar, right? So that the our own style we are creating, and it is inherited from style, that is activity theme. That means the whatever the current activity theme is there, you are extending it into the no action bar, and where you just specify the property that my activity does not contain any action bar. So for that, just see that item equal to sub attribute you are specifying, that Android Windows action bar false, right? That means now if you utilize this theme for your activity, then it does not contain any action bar into your activity. Are you getting this thing? Hello? Sound nahi aavto kon bole cha? હેલો, સમજાય છે બધાને?
યસ સર, યસ સર.
બસ જાગતા રહેજો બધા. ઓકે, નાઉ ધ નેક્સ્ટ થિંગ, ધેર આર સર્ટન પ્રોપર્ટીઝ આર ધેર ધેટ યુ કેન યુટિલાઇઝ ટુ સેટ ફોર ધ એક્શન બાર. ઓકે, સો ફર્સ્ટ થિંગ that you need to create the object of action bar first. Okay, so that we are doing action bar equal to get action bar, and we set a certain method. Now remember that only necessary method you should set. I have just created one example right here to just explore the different methods, but all these methods should not directly write for your action bar. Okay, because few methods will do the contradiction with other method. So whatever the method is required for your purpose, you should use only that. Like say that the first property that we are seeing, set display show title enable, and we are passed the boolean parameter false. So that means the activity title bar, right, that title is not clickable, right? When you write the false, the title is not enabled, so it is disabled over there. Another thing, action bar dot display use logo enable, and you pass the display logo. So display logo, that means what, right, that it will show the whatever the logo drawable resource you pass, that will be set as a logo of action bar. By default, what happens, it takes the logo of application logo. But if you wish to customize for any specific activity, you can do that thing. Another property that we are seeing, that set display show home enable false. So it will make that home button enable false. But if you keep it true, right, it will create the home activity. When you click on that, that parent activity will display on your screen. Another thing, that set subtitle, right? Like say that when you are using the Gmail application, and when you go in Gmail, that current title is Gmail, and within under that thing, right, subtitle is display like the inbox or the outbox or the sent mail, right? So that kind of things you can set. Just see, subtitle inbox is set, right? So that is the example that we have. Another thing, that we are setting the title of it, right? So just see that label view specified, that important are there. So how you can set the title, subtitle, or you can disable the home button, or you can enable the home button. All these things can be done with action bar, with the number of method is available to do so. Again, I want to clear this thing, that on this particular slide, only few method that is listed on your book, that is given right here. But there are so many other methods are also there. You can see the documentation of Android on developer.android.com to know a multiple methods available to populate your action bar. Let's see the remaining one. Set home button enable is equal to true. So it make your home button enable. Another thing, display use logo, that is enable false. That means it will not use the logo of your application. Now just see that when you want to use the second method, that is set display use logo enable. So before it, you need to write the display use logo enable false. That means it will not use your application logo, but whatever the logo you set, that should be come over there. Okay. And the another one, the set display home as up enable true. So up enable true, what it makes, so it will just show you a tiny arrow before that title, right? So when you click on that back arrow, it will go in a back activity, right? So that is the home enable, up enable is true, right? So these kind of option that you can set to your action bar. Are you getting this thing? Hello.
Yes sir.
Okay, can I request you to all just on the video? Okay, two students are there. Vijay, kya gaya chalu karin island gaya na? Hello.
No sir.
બીજા કોઈ સ્ટુડન્ટ નો વિડીયો અહીં દેખાતો નથી, એનો મતલબ એમ કે બે ત્રણ સ્ટુડન્ટ ત્યાં છે, બાકીના બધા સુઈ ગયા. કેવું નથી આમાં, સારું ચેક કરતું રહેવું પડે. ઓકે, ફાઇન. બાકીના ગયા?
સર, આના ઉપરથી ખબર પડી ગઈ ને કોલેજ કેટલા મેકઅપ કરીને આવે છે.
આઈ શુડ નોટ કમેન્ટ ઓન ધેટ. ઓકે, લેટ્સ કન્ટિન્યુ ટુ અવર lecture. Okay, now we have already seen that how we can set the number of properties of xn bar. Another thing, right, what is the look and feel of xn bar? So it is by default, whatever the theme you have selected for your application, that will apply over there. But in many situations, you want to create a custom xn bar for your activity. So it is also possible that say that you want to create your xn bar that have the background color is something different, or you want to set some graphics as a background, or say some shape drawable should be there, or you need to set the gradient over there. So all these things is possible. What you need to do that you need to set the background drawable for that. Okay, just see customizing the xn bar background example that I have given on this current slide. Again, you need to create the object and then refer your resources. And right now you see that we are creating the drawable resource by using R, that is the get resource dot get drawable R dot drawable dot gradient header. Now what is gradient header? So that gradient we have created in shape drawable. So that gradient is now available here, and we can set this thing. So xn bar dot set background drawable, that our drawable we have set over there. So what happened? Our xn bar's background can be changed. So how you can customize the background of xn bar? Now some of the another thing that we can see right here, that is handling application icon click. Like somebody click on home icon or some the logo, then how to react? That you want to make the toast message or move to some another home activity or the sub activity, or say the about us dialogue should be there, or any kind of word that you want to do, right? So how you can add the listeners to that? So handling application icon click that we are discussing right here. So for that we need to override one method, that is on option item selected method. Within activity you need to write this method, outside your this thing the on create method. Okay, okay. Now just see that here we pass item dot get id in a switch case. So from where we get this item reference? So again just see one parameter we have as menu item. That means on whatever the menu item you are clicking, right, on xn bar, whatever the option you see, that all are the part of menu item. In short, you just see that xn bar have all those option that is listed in this menu item option. So you can get all these things. So on whatever the icon you have clicked, you can get the ID of this thing by using item dot get item ID. Now we need to just compare it that if matched to our targeted object, then we need to do certain things. Like see that a case one that we have specified, that is android dot r dot id dot home, that denote that you have click on home icon. So when you click on home icon, what you want to do? So we need to start one activity. Which activity? That we have mentioned in our explicit intent, that is xn bar activity dot class. And one important thing that is given right here on this slide, that is intent dot add flags, intent dot flag activity dot clear top. Now what is the use of this thing? Can anybody say this thing? Koine khyal chhe flag chena mate set karvama aave? हेलो इफ यू नो यू कैन से यस अदरवाइज आई कैन एक्सप्लेन
नो सर
फुल सेट करी सकी એટલે
अच्छा कौन बोले छे एक જ સ્ટુડન્ટ બોલે કોઈ વન બાય વન
ટ્રુ ફુલ સેટ કરી સકી એટલે બુલિયન
No. Okay. As when we have started the explanation of Android, right? At that time, I am explaining the activity. At that time, what I have defined that for that activity create in an application, all activity created a stack, right? So there are a number of activity arranged in that particular stack form. Now, when you jump from one activity to another activity and from another to another sub activity, what happened? They have a created one path. Like say that when you come from home activity to some activity A to B, B to C. So when you click back button, it go in a reverse order from B to A to dashboard or the home, right? But if you wish that when you start certain activity, it should not come to the back of this thing. Let's take one example. When you do the login, right? Ekvar login thai gaya pachi tame dashboard ma jao, pachu back karo to login form na aavu joye. Correct? So to remove all top activity or to clear all top activity, you can add this flag. Intent.add flag, intent.flag activity clear top. So when this activity start, that means action bar dot activity dot class start, it will clear all top activity. So when you click back button, it will just close your entire application, but it will not go into back. Are you getting this thing? Samjhai chesu kevo mangu chu?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay, any doubt in this thing? કોઈ ને ના સમજાણું હોય તો હું રિપીટ કરી શકું એને. ઓકે, સો લેટ્સ ગો ટુ ધી નેક્સ્ટ વન. નાવ ધી નેક્સ્ટ ટોપિક ઇઝ ધી મેનુ, રાઈટ? હાઉ યુ કેન ક્રિએટ મેનુ ઓર ધી ઇન્ટ્રોડક્શન ઓફ ધી એન્ડ્રોઇડ મેનુઝ વી હેવ. સો જસ્ટ સી દેટ ઓન યોર સ્ક્રીન ડિફરન્ટ ટાઈપ્સ ઓફ મેનુઝ અવેલેબલ. So first one is the icon menu is there, right? That is already deprecated in Android 3.0. Nowadays only three types of menus available in Android. One is the option menu that you can see at in this slide at right side. Okay, add subject, insert smiley, delete thread and setting, all these are the option menu. So when you click on three dots available on action bar, it will create the option menu. Another one is the context menu. When you do the long press on any item on Android, it will open the context menu. If you have registered it, right, then it is known as the context menu. And the third one, that is the pop-up menu, that is the lighter version of the context menu. When you just do a single click on any item, and it will show you a pop-up menu that you can utilize. So what is sub menu, right? If you have added another menu as a item of a main menu, it is known as sub menu. And in menu item, you can add checkbox, radio group, button, and action providers, right? All these things that can be added over there. We'll see the each thing in detail. Okay, just see on your screen that we have three types of menu, option menu, context menu and pop-up menus. And each menu have their certain handler or some the methods that you need to perform to create it, or whenever you select any item within that menu, right, that particular method will call. Okay, so for option menu, on create option menu is there, where you can create the option menu for your activity. And when you select any menu item from that option menu, then on option, item selected will call. Similarly, in context menu, just see that only option menu is replaced with the context menu. Just see on create context menu and on context item selected. And nowadays, right, after that API number 4, they have given one more method for this, register for context menu, and you can pass view parameter over there. So what is this view? That view can be anything, like say that any layout, linear layout or the constraint layout or the any other layouts that you want to specify, or you can set it for some text view and all other things, right? Now, third one, that is the pop-up menu. So as I said, it's a lighter version of the context menu. How we can say it's a lighter version? Because in a context menu, you need to do the long press on any views available on your activity. But in the case of pop-up, when you just do the single click, a pop-up menu will arrive. So how you can create pop-up menu? So of course you need to create the object of pop-up menu, and two parameter you need to pass over there. First one is a current context, and another is that's a view. Right here, just see that we have passed button. Button is also a one type view that we are setting right here. Another thing, that when you click on that button, which menu should be displayed? So here, what we are specifying, menu, a pop-up menu dot infillet, and we just specify that r dot menu dot my pop-up menu. So what is this r dot menu dot my pop-up menu? So this is the XML layout of menu where we have created all menus that we are infillating right here. So what happened when you click on that button as a pop-up? This r dot menu dot my pop-up menu will be there, right? And if you wish to set the listener on this thing, the third line that you can utilize, pop-up menu dot set on menu item click listener. On this slide, I have just given the all summary, right, for all three menu options. Now we are going to learn this thing in detail. And my friends, right, this Android menu, it's really important according to your GTU theory exam, as well as the exercise number 21 that is given in your practical list, that create a menu and they have certain color option, like say that red, green and blue, and when you click on this thing, that should change the color of your background, right? And this exercise is many times asked in your practical exam. So this topic is really important for us. Okay, another thing is, you all know, right, we are using the free version of Zoom. Our meeting will end in next 10 minutes, so I will just give you the new link after one this meeting is over, and you should rejoin it. Okay, I just get the alert of this thing. Okay, now let's create menu using Java. We have two ways to create menu. One is by using Java coding, and another is the XML way, right? XML way is always easy, and we should prefer that way to create menu when we are doing programming. But for theory examination, they ask two times that create menu using Java method. So that's why we need to discuss this particular topic, that how you can create menu using Java code. So to create menu object, we have add method, right? That add method that you can utilize to populate your menu. That add method have your total four parameters. Just see that the third line, menu item equal to menu dot add group ID, menu ID, menu item order, and menu item tag. So what is the meaning of this parameter? Let's see. First one, that's a group value to separate menu item. Like in Windows, if you see the file menu or the edit menu, in between you just see a one line is separating certain menu item. So it's just doing the grouping of menu item that is related to some task. So if you need to create group within your menu, you can add the group ID. And when you are working with Java, these all things, right, group ID, menu ID and menu item order, all are the integer values. But in the case of menu item tags, it should provide the string. So first one, that's a group ID, as we have discussed. Another one, that's a unique identifier for each menu item. So you can say it's a variable name for your menu item to identify each item uniquely, right? So whenever a user is clicking on any particular item, you can identify this thing and execute certain code. So for that, we have to specify the menu item. Another thing, that's a menu item order. So where you can specify that in your group, in which particular order your menu items should be displayed. It should start from 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on, right? Now, if you want to rearrange, you can given this index to any particular order, like say that first you specify 3, then 2 and 1 and 0. So what happens? 0 item always come first, then 1, then 2 and so on. So that is the menu item order that you can specify. And finally, menu item text. So that is the text that is going to be displayed as a item text, or the, you can say the caption, right, that user can see on screen. Menu item ID, that is for the developer. Group ID, that is for the developer. Item order, right, it will reflect as developer side, as the user side. Whatever the order you specified, it will arrange your items in that particular order. And the text, that is for the user side, that user can identify that which particular item that is added. Okay, so that is the add method. That's really important. It can also be asked in 2 marks question. Now this is the example that we are creating right here. You need to create a fresh project in Android Studio, and if you write this much coding over there, then you are able to create this thing. In old syllabus of Android in GTU, this is actually exercise number 13. But if you see the current syllabus of our mobile computing, then exercise number 21 is there, where they suggest that you need to create one menu, option menu or context menu, whatever the menu you wish to create, you can create it. And that should have 3 options, red, green and blue. And whatever the item you click on, that, that color should reflect on the background of your activity. So we are performing this example right here with the technique of Java code. So just see, for the XML side, we have created one linear layout, and ID of this thing is LL, that is linear layout. So whatever the specific item, either red, green or blue from the menu is clicked, we want to change the background color of our linear layer. Okay, now just see, to create option menu, we are creating option menu right here. If you wish to create context menu, method need to be checked. So first let's create the context menu. So what you need to do, you need to override 2 methods. First 2 methods that we have listed, that is on create option menu, that will create option menu for you. And when you click on red or say green or blue, then it will execute another method, that is on item selected. Now in each this method, like say that, let's take first method first, on create option menu, where we are calling another method, that is create menu, and we pass the menu argument over there. So from where we can get that menu object? This is the parameter of our this thing, menu, our method parameter menu, right? So that we are passing in create menu. Just see right here, you are seeing my cursor or not? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now just see a create menu, that's a user defined method that we have created. Just see right here, we have a created create menu, and we are getting that the actual menu parameter in here as a formal menu parameter. So that menu that we can utilize to add our item. So just see menu dot add, we are passing all these 4 options: group ID, item ID, item order and the text. So we have utilized group as 0, so we are not creating any group right here. Only one group is there, that's a 0. Another, the that's the item ID. So that is 012. You can make it any valid integer, like say that if you wish to create 100, 200 and 300, it is your choice, right? Any valid integer that you can create over there. And it, next thing, that's a sort order that we are utilizing 0, 1 and 2. So in this particular sequence, like say that 0 for the red, so you can see the left hand side screenshot of activity is there. Red is the first item, right? Green item order is 1, so it is on second, and blue, that is 2, so it comes right here as a last item. But if you change red is 2 and blue is 0, so blue comes first and red comes at third position. So how it becomes the sort order, and the last parameter as the text that is available on your screen. So when on create option menu, will call this menu is created. Now another method that we need to discuss, that is on item selected. So just see right here what we are doing, that menu item, on whatever the menu item you have clicked, that comes as an object of menu item right here. Okay, so we can utilize this thing, item dot get item ID. So it will return this thing 0, 1 and 2. So that we are passing in a case 0, 1 and 2. If item ID is 0, that means user has clicked on red. If it is 1, then user have clicked on green. And if it is 2, then it is blue. So according to whatever the item is clicked, we are setting linear layout dot set background color and color dot RGB that 25500. So it is for red, green and blue, that all we are setting. Now my meeting time is over. I'm just resending the link of meeting and we will discuss the next thing on new meeting. Okay.
Yes, sir.